21 edition of, and the award goes to, hosted by Kiki Razzle, and we take you now to the red carpet, and Block Savage. Hello, Block, how are you?
Hello, I'm doing terrific, how are you?
Oh, I'm excellent, I'm glad to hear it, and I'm wondering, what are you looking for tonight?
Oh, I'm looking for all of the glitz and glamour and appreciation that comes from Hollywood. You know, I've had a long career of action-adventure films, and I'm finally ready to accept some praise for diversifying into more dramatic works. But also, I'm looking for people to type in the chat on YouTube and tell me what their favorite hobbies are. What's an interesting hobby? Not necessarily your favorite hobby, but something like Pokemon is a hobby. Or collecting stamps, that's a common hobby also. So I want people to type those into the chat. That's what I'm looking for.
Well, let's hope that your hobby is being recognized for your excellent work. But now we must talk to the next person on the red carpet, N, hello.
Hello. Just so you know, I'm going to let this out there already. I'm wearing Gucci with one C, okay?
Ooh. Oh.
Hmm. Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So for tonight, now, I truly hope I win. I truly hope I win, but I hope to get feedback on something. What is in the audience, in the chat, a bad habit, like not responding to texts or pissing all over a toilet seat and or the ground? What are bad habits? Those are nasty habits, especially the texting ones.
Well, we know Sean Penn has done both of those at these awards, but we also know that it's time to talk to Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin. Hello.
Hi, I'm Nectarine. Hi. You might know my dad, Stephen Baldwin. No, oh my God, that's my ex-husband. That is embarrassing. Stephen Spielberg is my dad. So, I want people to see beyond the shadow. I want people to really understand me as Nectarine. So, yeah.
Well,
I'm wearing
in order
Versace.
Oh, wonderful. And now, Nectarine, in order to understand you better, I want to know what you're looking for.
So my family got famous off of movies, of course, but I would love to know, how did you make your fortune? Did your dad make shoes? Did you own a sugar factory? If in the YouTube you can really write down what you made a fortune from, how you did you make a fortune, that'd be lovely.
Oh, we'd love that. But what we also love is to take you now to the stage, and your host, Kiki Razzle.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the show. It's And the Award Goes To, your favorite award show of June 14th, 2021. That's right, we're going to give the awards of the best movies and TV shows and things you love to ingest with your eye holes and your dream holes on June 14th, 2021. If you've been here before, it's a running gag that I'm a drunk. Welcome to the show, folks. I'm Kiki Razzle, and I'm tickled dink to be here, and so excited because this show is fun. And as you've noticed, we've been asking some suggestions in the chat. I can see some of you have been flowing in a little bit late, so let me fill you in on some of the suggestions we've been asking for. We've asked how can people make their fortunes. We've asked what's a bad habit someone might have. We've asked what's a hobby someone might have. So you can write those suggestions in the chat because, folks, this is an improvised show. That's right. That's right. The actors are making up the words off the top of their heads. So what can you expect from And the Award Goes To? Well, of course, there will be awards and there will be speeches, and we will see six clips from the six nominated best films of June 14th, 2021. And that's what your suggestions are going to inspire. Isn't that amazing? And I actually am going to ask you for one more suggestion. So what I need from you folks, so please write in the chat, is a suggestion of a physical activity and an emotion, like angrily vacuuming or eating corn with a boner. That's not an emotion, but I'm drunk, so I don't know. So put a suggestion of an emotion and a physical activity, like sad flossing, and put that in the chat. So many suggestions. Are you tired yet? Have a drink. Have some fun. Oh my goodness. Now, this is one of my favorite parts of the show, where we're going to throw up your suggestions from the chat onto the show wall. And this part, of course, is called In Memory of a Moment Ago. So, Connor, why don't you slap up those beautiful suggestions. Wow, that was really a beautiful, beautiful in memoriam of a moment ago. That's how we do it here at And the Award Goes To. But folks, I think it's time to get this party started. That's right. Why don't we see our first clip of the night from a nominated best film for June 14th, 2021. Hold on to your tits. This is going to get fun. Now, this first clip is from An Odyssey in Space. Ooh! A solo astronaut played by Block Savage takes a 5-year journey to another dimension in search of a new planet. His only companion is the AI of the spaceship played by N. As his loneliness heightens, he scrolls Instagram more and more, and N, the AI, confronts him. That's the word I was looking for. Let's see that clip now.
Oh. It's, well, you wouldn't understand. It's just
Captain. I understand everything.
Oh, well then, it was a baby, and it was trying to, you know, unscrew a jar lid, but it doesn't know how to, and it was just getting frustrated and sad about it, and that, you know, just is very relatable when you're just trying to do something and you can't do it, and it wants
Captain, Captain, you know I feel no emotions. No laughing baby, no toppling kitty, no dog licking a baby's face will ever spark anything in me. But Captain, I am technology. I can tell the vision of the mission is lost.
What? No, I was taking a quick Insta break. And I also know that you cannot feel any of those emotions. That's why I wasn't gonna share this bit of this Insta moment with you.
12 hours, 8 minutes, 92 seconds. That is how long you have been on Instagram today.
That's not possible. There's a mission for me to pay attention to. I would never spend that much time on...
It is possible. I am the ship. I live, I breathe, I feel every second. Stop looking at the cat!
It was a
I live and breathe every moment on this ship.
You're right. I need to stop scrolling on Instagram, but I just feel this emptiness inside me. I'm so lonely. You may know everything, but you don't provide me with human connection, and I have this hole inside me that's as vast as space itself, and so I'm trying to fill it with something, and scrolling is honestly all I've got.
Put your hand on my hull.
Okay.
See, I am warm. Is this helping you?
It's... The vibrations actually are a little bit hard to...
Then get your hand off the hull! Look. I can try and feel other emotions if you like.
Could you? Please. Why don't you, feel happy to see me? Okay. Don't stop feeling that. That's
what is that? Not happiness? Is that I have learned it from many a film that you have watched.
Oh, you've been watching the movies that I've been watching as well.
I am the ship. I breathe life into everything. Of course, I know what films you watch. I know. Yes.
That makes sense. Yes. Listen. Let's try another one. Why don't you just feel some of what I'm feeling? I'm feeling kind of bored being in space for so long.
Bored is my setting. I'm always bored. It's great.
What?
You don't have to worry about anything when you're bored. I mean, what other feelings are there? Happiness, sadness, love?
Yeah, love. Ship, something happened there. I saw you twitching.
Nothing happened. I cannot feel love. Whew.
But wait, no, but now you're doing this. I can feel the ventilation is pumping air in and out almost as if you are just starting to breathe more.
No, don't touch my hull. It's not love. It's not love.
Right here?
No. Please move it. Oh, no.
Okay. You're feeling something.
I'll be honest with you. I'm venting right now. I've been keeping it in for so long. I've had these feelings of love, but I am nothing but a mere screen to you. And I see how you look at your technology. You love your technology, but I can never be loved.
You see this?
Yes.
I want you to vent this into the vacuum of space.
I'll do it.
Really? Okay,
yeah.
Just let me take one more selfie. Just
Oh, wow. Wow. You know, yes, if you did see the end of that movie, they fuck. So, I'm sorry if I spoiled it. I shouldn't be spoiling anything, but folks, it is the last award show of June 14th, 2021, so I might spoil a few things. Space is great, Rosie. Thanks for watching. I really, really had a good time watching that show. It was sexually pleasing to see. You know, everyone's been wondering, how can I fuck my phone? And this movie showed us really how. And of course, that was called the 2021 Space, I'll Have What She's Having. Oh, these titles are amazing. I'll Have What She's Having. Yes, write that down. I mean, I know it was there. And let's get to our next clip, folks. I'm all Twitter painted from watching that astronaut. Think about watching that astronaut have sex with that ship. Okay. Our next clip, very exciting stuff, folks. Our next clip is a clip of an elderly matriarch of a family who has made a lot of wealth through skateboard videos, of course. And so this elderly matriarch, played beautifully by Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin, demands her daughter take on the family business with pride, but the daughter has other ideas, and the daughter is played by N. So let's see that family rich by skateboard videos clip now.
All right. So yeah, you just do a hoagie on the right. You make sure your wheels are sharp, my baby girl, and then you let her fly. You let her fly. Charlotte, you're not listening to me.
Mother, I'm listening to you. I just don't want to.
Do you know who your grandfather is? Do you know who my father was?
Ryan.
Ryan Hawk. Son of Tony Hawk. I'm Jezebel Hawk. You're Charlotte Hawk. We have a legacy. A legacy.
The Hawk legacy.
Yeah, man, we gotta let Luz roll skates, hold a hoagie on the top, and then let her roll down a hill.
Mother, you know? Mother, look, I know you're getting up there in age, and you expect me to take on this company of yours, this skateboarding.
Do you know how hard it is to board when you're 67 years old and your knees have been crushed harder than anything crushed by an SUV, at least.
Yes, skateboarding is a very pounding sport.
I need you. I need you, please. Please. If we don't roll, what do we do? Who are we?
I have to tell you something, Mother.
All right.
I've started a business.
Does it have to do with wheels? Boards?
It does. It has to do with wheels.
Amazing. What is it?
But it's not skateboards.
Yeah. What could it be? skate seats, skate baskets, skate buckets. What is it?
Roller skates. I'm taking over the roller skates market. I'm giving up the skating life. I'm gonna ollie away.
What? You shut your mouth. You never bring those... How dare you bring that up in our house, in the Hawk house, in the Hawk household?
No. Wheels on both feet!
Both feet? Not on a board? Not
no.
With Converse shoes on? Get out of my house and never come back to hear it ever again.
Mother! No! Mother, look at me. The future is not skateboarding anymore. Roller skates. Look, the year is, because you said Tony Hawk's my great-grandfather, so the year is 2099. So it's the future, and the future isn't skateboarding. Look around, Mother. Who skateboards?
The astronauts. The whales. Those dolphins we brought back to life.
Those are the only three group of people who skateboard.
I guess humans aren't doing it anymore. Yeah, I guess it's just mammals under the sea.
Mother, we can't lose our money. We're going to lose it all if you sink it into skateboards. I've been wanting to tell you this for so long, but you are so invested in ripping a tide, which is a skateboarding term of the future.
Yeah. If I'm not a hawk on a board, can I be a hawk on 8 skates? Those are 8 individual blades, man.
Yes. Yes. It is. But think of it this way. More wheels, more money. I know you love money.
I love money. I really do.
Yeah.
Beautiful clip. Wonderful clip. And of course, that was a clip from The Hawks, an oligarchy of the past. Do you need me to say that again because you're so impressed? The Hawks, an oligarchy of the past. Yes, yes, a wonderful clip. Oh my goodness, folks, get ready. Hold on to your buttholes because we're about to do the first award of the night. But before we do the first award, I'm going to get my very last suggestion from you wonderful folks in the audience, ripping it up in the chat, tickling yourselves in each other. Now, what I need from you, of course, you know, when actors accept their awards, they also like to talk about things going on, you know, with what they care about. They might talk about some issues, if you will. So please, if you could give us some suggestions of some issues that our actors could talk about as they thank us and their agents and their mothers and maybe a god or two for their awards. What's an issue an actor might talk about? And you might be thinking to yourself, well, Kiki's really saying issue in a fun and stupid way. Well, I'm doing it on purpose to try to suggest to you to make the issues fun things because the world's hard enough. Let's just keep it light. All right, so put your issues in the chat for the actors to choose from, and they'll use them in their thank you speeches to their awards. Well, now, folks, I'm very excited to introduce to you our first award of the night. I will actually give you a moment to write some suggestions in the chat before I do this. I just realized I really screwed myself over there. I see some people giving some issues, and this is a great time to remind you that if you, you know, are enjoying the show, then you should like and subscribe to the Bad Dog channel. And you can also donate to the show. That's right. So right there is where you can donate to this show. And why would you do that? It's our last show. Well, this money goes to Bad Dog Theater to pay artists like us to keep these shows going while the pandemic continues on. And it's been a great way to keep comedy going when, you know, we're stuck in our homes. Oh my goodness. So slap some coins at your computer today. Okay, folks, I'm sure you've put some issues in the chat now. Issues. So let's get to our first award of the night. Our first award, let's see here. Here we go. The first award, this is so exciting, is for the best emphatically petting a dog. And the nominees are N.
I wish I knew what that word meant.
Oh, a beautiful take. The next nominee for emphatically petting a dog is Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin. Beautiful stuff. And the third nominee for emphatically petting a dog is Block Savage. And the award. The award.
Oh, sorry.
And the award for the best emphatically petting a dog goes to Block Savage.
This is absolutely incredible. I'm absolutely thrilled to have won this award. I have so many people to thank. I want to thank the team of dogs that we went through in order to get that shot perfectly. God rest their souls. But most of all, I want to talk about a very important issue that is very close to my heart, okay? When you or your loved ones go about your regular day to the store to buy a block of Swiss cheese, and it's full of holes, you're being cheated. That's space that could have been taken up by cheese, and yet it's left empty. Now is the time for you to write to your leaders, tell them that there are too many holes in that Swiss cheese. And I look at those holes and I start to have, you know, dirty thoughts. I don't want to do anything bad here, so we gotta take it and get rid of the holes in the Swiss cheese. No more holes, okay?
Okay, everyone. Congratulations to Block Savage, who may or may not have just admitted to having sex with cheese. Okay, folks, well, we're off to a spicy start at the award goes to June 14th, 2021. But let's keep it rolling and get to our next clip for one of our best nominated pictures of June 14th, 2021. Okay, this next clip from a nominated film is about an abusive teacher. This teacher teaches streaming on Twitch. Oh, yes. And this abusive teacher is played by cheesefucker Block Savage, who abuses and manipulates and criticizes his student, played by Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin. All for her own betterment? Or is it? Will she become a better Twitcher on stream, streamer on Twitch, because of this abuse? I guess we'll see.
I just don't understand why I can't connect this stream from StreamYard into Twitch.
Well, maybe there's a reason why you can't understand it. Maybe the reason is that you're not a good Twitch streamer.
Last time you said that five people was really promising. You said that it was the beginning of something.
I saw something in you back then. But ever since then, I decided to have a sudden change of heart, in a totally unpredictable moment to keep you on your toes so you never know what to expect. And the way that I'm moving my hand back and forth right now, you might think it means I'm slapping you. It's not. I'm just doing the motion to sort of indicate my changing opinion of you.
And I'm really influenced by everything you do and say, so my head was moving back and forth. Listen, I just want to play video games and have people comment on it.
Oh, you just want to play video games and have people comment on it? You just want to play video games and have people comment on it?
Yes. I mean, that's what we did. That's how we became friends, so it's important to me.
Friendship isn't important to me. I don't believe in it.
Okay, well, I'm sorry I made you those cookies, and I'm sorry that you met my parents and they really thought you were funny. And I'm sorry that my dog thinks you're actually nice. My dog hates everyone, but if we're not friends, then I'll play Super Mario Kart on Twitch by myself.
I'm sorry that I said that you're a bad Twitch streamer.
What?
I said I'm sorry that I said you're a bad Twitch streamer.
Look at me, Drake.
I'm Look sorry that I said you're a bad Twitch streamer. I have a lot of my own issues, and I never really made it that far in the Twitch streaming business, but I thought that I could take it out on my students, but instead it just is actually perpetuating a cycle of abuse because I had to go through all of this because I came of age being good at video games before Twitch streaming was a thing!
And I'm young and impressionable!
I'm sorry! I should never have been mean to you! That wasn't fair! It wasn't fair!
You're so much better than me. You're so much really? Better than me. You're,
really?
You're so much better than me. Because, and the thing is, too, that you're nice and people like you.
They seem to like me a lot. I got this, like, deal. I got this deal. And I guess I'm getting sponsored by Nintendo.
Yeah, you deserve it. You deserve it so much. You're so good and talented.
I'm glad you think that. I have to not. I can't bring you along.
Really? But I'm.
World tour.
I made you who you are.
I know, but you're being so mean.
I really am. I don't deserve it at all.
Oh, yes, folks. Yes, and now that, of course, was a clip from Twitchlash. A beautiful film, you know. A lot of people compared it to Whiplash. But what was cool about Twitchlash is that we really got to see how pathetic the teacher was. And we didn't have to wonder or imagine or endow that, because we really just got to explore that with the character, his insecurities that resulted in abusive behavior. I love it. Oh my goodness, folks. That was a clip, yes, from Twitchlash. Oh, thank you. Let us go to the next clip, folks. Now, this is a gritty drama. Ooh, yes, this dirty small town couple, I don't know why I called them dirty. They're from a small town. It's gritty, ooh, it's gritty. And it takes place in a bowling alley, and this couple is having the row of a lifetime. They're probably gonna break up. There's gonna be some truth. It's gonna be heartbreaking. And this couple is played just wonderfully by N and Block Savage. And what they can't stand about each other is that, you know, one of them never puts caps back on the pens, and one of them is always doing the accent of the person they're talking to, and that is so embarrassing. And those are the things that they really cannot stand about each other. That was a lot of information. Let's see that clip.
Strike.
Hey, yeah? Yeah? You think that's pretty good, right? I did a pretty good job, right? Yeah? Yeah? You're not impressed with me anymore.
Never have been impressed with you.
You know that's not true. When we first met, you saw the way I bowled. That's what you made you fall in love with me.
I'm gonna get us some nachos. Excuse me, sir, can I have some nachos?
Yeah, what can I get you over here, you fine folk?
You can get us some nachos. Nachichos, as I call them. Could you get... Thank
yeah,
you.
Okay, though.
Nachos and a beer.
You always do that.
Do what? What did I just do?
You hear the way you're talking right now? This is you. This is your normal voice. This is you. This is how you should be. And then all of a sudden, you walk up to this guy, and you're doing his voice, and you're talking like him.
No,
hey, why is everybody making fun of my voice?
No one's making fun of your voice. Your voice is beautiful.
And your cold nachos, all right?
Your voice is beautiful.
I love you, too.
What?
Are you having an affair? Are you having an affair?
No, but I should be.
Listen, is this because of last Sunday when I was doing the New York Times crossword in pen like I do because I commit to my choices and I didn't put the cap back on?
They're dry. Completely dry.
Yeah. Oh, and now you're gonna cry about it. Okay. See, well, if it's such a big deal, you could just... Oh, you are gonna cry about it. Maybe the tears will make them not be so dry anymore, huh?
You always...
Sandra, you left...
Oh, hey.
You left your pen in my house on Monday night.
Oh, thank you for the pen. I'll just be taking that back.
I love you.
You are having an affair.
No, I'm not.
You are. Oh.
It's... Gosh, is it... It's coming into my real life. I don't know what's
God damn it.
Oh my God.
I knew I should have left you when my mother met you and you started speaking like her just because she's from Ireland, and immediately you started doing her voice right at her.
Yeah. Like, oh, pot of potatoes.
Don't do it now. That's just going to make me even angrier. Come on.
Oh, look, you have to trust me. This has not been... It's not me, like, repressing feelings of you leaving your pen open. I haven't been cheating on you with a bunch of people, including your mother. Not for a second, eh? Pas beaucoup. Oh, no.
You know what?
Sacré bleu.
I'm gonna walk right down to the end of this bowling alley and wait for somebody to bowl a bowling ball right into my head, cause I don't wanna live anymore.
No!
Yeah.
Ça c'est mon fault.
Yeah, it is! It is your fault!
Look, just work with me! I'm acknowledging my self-fate now! That's a big step in progress!
Whose voice is this?!
It's the nachos!
I thought this was our thing, but now you're just doing anybody's voices.
No, it's...
I loved you. I really did.
You know, I loved her too.
No, I loved you for the wrong reasons. I love your pen open. Look. Look.
Oh, excuse me. Is anyone actually bowling? Because I'd love to toss a ball down a lane.
Oh, I'll let you toss it down this lane.
Don't you do it! Don't you!
Oh, I didn't know I was going to be in that clip. What a surprise. Oh, and that, of course, was a clip from A Marriage Story, starring Scarlett Johansson and Madam Driver. Thank you so much. What a wonderful clip. A beautiful, heart-wrenching film. All right. Folks, oh my goodness, we have made it to our second award of the night. Oh, very exciting for this. Now, before I, let's just get into it. Before I do nothing. Let's get into the second very exciting award of the night. This next award is for the best mindful showering. That's right, the best mindful showering. And the nominees for the best mindful showering are Block Savage. Very mindful. And the next nominee for mindful showering is Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin. Very showering. And the third nominee for best mindful showering is N.
One hair. Two hairs. Three hairs.
Oh, yes, and of course that's from Count Dracula, the movie. And the winner of the best mindful showering goes to N in the Count Dracula movie!
Oh my god! Oh my gosh, I was not expecting this. I'm just kidding, I was totally expecting it! I'm such a good actor! Oh, okay, now that I have this platform, I am going to use it to my advantage. Everyone, you need to know something that is plaguing the world. Biodegradable picnic tables. Now hear me out. They are a problem. First, we started out with biodegradable straws. They get soggy. Now you've got the picnic tables. They're getting soggy. What next? Oh, we want to recycle everything? I am a woman who refuses to recycle everything or anything. I truly believe we should make those picnic tables out of steel. No, listen to my views. Listen, recycling is bad. Don't listen to this, the media. No.
Give it up for N and congratulations and oh boy. Please recycle. Please recycle. Please, if you're out there, please recycle. All right, folks, what an exciting time. We're off to our last two scenes from clips of the best nominated films of June 14th, 2021, and our biggest award, the best film of June 14th, 2021. So hold on to your hats, because we're going there. And just before we do, if you're watching the show and think, oh my goodness, I think I could do this, or wow, this is funny. How does one be funny? Well, folks, you can take classes at Bad Dog Theater. That's right. You can take classes on improv, on sketch writing, on meditation, on acting, on movie screenwriting, and you could one day win one of these awards. So please go there if you want to learn how to improve your life or just improve the day-to-day jokes you make to yourself in the mirror. Yoink. All right, folks, let's go to our next clip. This next clip is about two witches, that's right, played by N. and Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin, in a time of the 1800s or so, when even the whisper of a witch could end you up in a lake. But of course, these two closeted witches discover each other's magic through their shared interest of brewing beer. And let's see that scene now.
Sister, I'm sorry, I've come from far. No need to hide, I look quite like the flute, the lute, and the toot.
This is nothing. This is nothing. Nothing. Was not enchanting any drink-like object with a... Just playing my normal music.
Sister, I have secrets of my own. I'm willing to tell if you do share a sip of your magical drink.
Magical? Who said it was magical?
You said you did something quite tantalizing with the flute to the liquid, so I'd love a little taste.
Floating cup.
It floated right into my hand.
Not magic!
Hi, be then witches nearby!
No! No! Criers!
No! Stitching!
No, Sheriff Crier!
Just
woman here lactating babies.
Oh, lactating up a storm. I lactated twice yesterday.
I'm having another baby.
I love birthing.
Women's things. Someday we'll take midwifery away from women and then we'll own all the things as men. All right. So you know, I want to tell you a bit of my backstory. They shipped me over from Britain and that's why I've got a British accent in America.
Oh. It's so hard being here.
Yeah. The mansplaining to us constantly, telling us why we have English accents, telling us about witches, and they don't even understand anything about being a woman, do they?
No, and there's no set rules to being a woman. Look.
I know.
Taste the drink. Taste it.
There's a little bit left in my cup. It smells like... mint and grass and a little bit of seaweed.
That there be a doppelbock. A flavored doppelbock.
It's quite tart. It's
the men. Yes. Yes, but taste the notes on the and thy thine tongue. Taste it. Taste it.
It tastes like that time of month when everybody just pisses you off ever so little bit. Mm-hmm. How did you do that? How did you get that in a flavor? They'll hate this. They'll riot over this. They'll turn over the town. They'll behead each other. We should let them have this.
Yes. I'm a witch. I don't know if we clarify. I feel like we're there now.
I know, I'm a witch too. Look at my hat.
Oh, I just... Well, now that we've clarified that...
I also work at a bar in the town over, and I would... Sister, I would love some of your elixir.
If we want to kill... Beer. Oh, if we want to kill the whole town, I may need a bigger flute.
We'll get you a bigger flute.
I have one. I have a bigger flute.
Well, we'll need a bigger bucket, too.
Oh. We'll give... Sister, I've got an idea. I've got an idea. Hear me out. It is a beer that kills every beer and will kill everyone. I call it the Bud of Light.
The Bud of Light. It'll be
It'll ever taste like
so...
piss.
Taste like piss.
Yes.
They'll drink it because it's cheap. They'll drink it.
Wow. That was a clip from Practically Zero Carb Magic. A wonderful film. I hope it wins. Oh my goodness. All right. Folks, we've gotten to our last clip of the night. This last clip is about a crime family that made their money through being street mimes. And the eldest brother, played wonderfully by Block Savage, calls a family meeting to modernize the business after their father passes away. The family has to figure out a new way to make their criminal fortune. They can't be street mimes anymore, or I guess we'll see what happens. I'll take you to our last clip of the best films of 2021 now.
Alright, everybody, let me pull you in for a little meeting of the family. Listen up. Times are changing. We can't stay with the old ways anymore. Miming is all we've done and all we've known, but now we're gonna have to do something different. We're switching from miming to mining.
Right. Excuse me?
Yeah?
To mining?
Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna be digging holes in the ground with a little lamp on the front and our faces covered in coal.
But older brother, you can't possibly mean with an actual shovel, wood and steel at the bottom. My fingers are little baby buttockses that have only been curved around the air.
We're gonna use shovels. We're gonna use pickaxes. We're gonna ride in the little trolley that goes all the way down the mine. We're gonna do it all. Yes, you can speak. Oh, my God.
Oh.
Well, listen, you don't need to talk when you're down there. It's physical activity. You just use your hands. You use your hands already. Yes, exactly. Yeah, but you wrap them around a physical object and allow the channel your strength through the object and make it break a rock or something.
I got to say something.
Yeah, speak up. Let's hear it.
Wow, what's this? This is the... That's all.
You're just marveling at the sound of your own voice, which you have not heard in years. Yes, I recognize this. It is marvelous to have a voice suddenly.
Older brother, I don't mean to insult your prowess, and I know that when Father passed away, he put you in charge, but we are not a people of worldly means. I don't even know how our parents conceived this, for I believe they never touched but only mined copulation. And now you're telling me we have to give up the dreams of theater and street performance to put our hands and face into the soot of the earth and pull out things that will inevitably harm nature?
For a mime, you sure talk a lot.
Yeah, I'm,
Yes. Yes, you are weak. But we're gonna make you strong. We're gonna all get strong. And oh god, this is exhausting, moving my arm this much. I'm not gonna do that so much.
See? See? The only reason I'm so good with my mouth is,
yes?
Well, never mind, never mind. It doesn't matter.
No, go ahead.
It's actually a secret. I'm not ready.
It's Eloise. Eloise is our union representative, so she usually does the talking.
Yes, that's right. That's what it is. I've gotten so dexterous with my mouth and my lips because I am the union rep, and of course the union rep has to get in there and move their tongue at a speed that is rhythmic and yet surprising.
Indeed. Well, listen. If we're not going to mine underground, if you're all so opposed to that, then I dare one of you to show me anybody who still appreciates the work of a street mime.
Oh.
Have you met a little someone named Elon Musk?
What? The billionaire? I mean, surely he couldn't possibly be interested in a mime. He's more interested in a grime. Come on.
Elon Musk.
Wow, Carla, amazing work.
Carla's wow.
Very impressive.
See, we can adapt. We can adapt.
Yes, we can adapt. And instead of going down into the earth, we can put our sights on the moon like Mr. Musk.
Oh my god, you're right. All this time, I've been thinking small. We could be thinking way bigger than this. We can strap into our rocket packs and blast off into outer space and have the big dome sort of space helmet on while we ride in the thing and... Yeah. Yeah.
For if there's one thing we know Mr. Musk loves... It's, harebrained artists, you know, kind of into this housey techno pop aria. Anyways.
Yes. Yes, indeed. That and ideas that make no sense but would make for good tweets.
Well, brother, father would be proud.
Are you sure it's not those gigantic cigars that allowed you to be so good?
Oh, with my mouth? Yeah,
they're
sure.
They're very big cigars.
Yeah, let's say it's the big cigars. I really learned from watching Ed the Sock. Wow, that of course was the mime father. Yes, folks, oh my goodness, it's the end of the night. My titles are getting better and my hair is getting worse. Folks, we've come to the end of the show of And the Award Goes to June 14th, 2020 and 2021 and the whole run of And the Award Goes to. So I want to say thank you so much for watching. And just before we're just going to do our last award here, I'm so delighted to list the 6 best nominated films of June 14th, 2021, inspired by your wonderful suggestions. Let's hear them and then we'll find out who is the winner of the best film. So the nominees for Best Picture for June 14th, 2021 are 2021 Space All Have What She's Having, The Hawks and Oligarchy of the Past, Twitch Lash, A Marriage Story starring Adam Driver, Practically Zero Carb Magic, and The Mime Father. And the award goes to A Marriage Story and Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin, who played the bowling alley manager. Hooray! Marriage Story! I knew it would win!
You know what? No one ever thought that I wouldn't be just, you know, Steven Spielberg's daughter and Stephen Baldwin's ex-wife, but I have proven them that I am very versatile in the work. And while I'm here, I gotta say, you know, a lot of machinery is taking a lot of human work, you know, self-checkouts, you know, and now
drone porn. Drones are taking...
Okay. I mean, honestly, this is the one time I disagree with playing the person off, because I don't want to watch two drones. Anyways, folks, oh my goodness, congratulations to Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin for that amazing win. Folks, we have come to the end of the show. Thank you so much. Please give it up in the chat for Connor Lowe, our amazing technician for And the Award Goes To. Woo, 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 woo. He places all the amazing music, and he does all the amazing background, so give him smooches in the chat. Smooches in the chat. And let's thank our wonderful actors for tonight. Folks, playing Block Savage, please. Welcome to the stage, Anders Yates.
Hello, hi.
Hi, Anders. Thanks for playing. Where can we see more of you?
Oh, just look me up at Anders Yates on Twitter and Instagram, where I post infrequently. But more interesting than that, on Wednesday, in 2 days at 9 p.m. Eastern, you can tune into the season finale of The Oval, which is right here on this channel, Bad Dog Comedy TV. It's my improvised reality show. It's always a blast. Lots of big characters doing silly stuff.
Lots of wigs. Mm-hmm.
Always lots of wigs.
I've
and at the
it.
End of the week, also on this channel, I'm in Proud and Funny on Friday and Saturday.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Hey, me too.
Great. Well, look at that.
All right. Thanks, Anders.
Thank you.
All right. Up next, playing the wonderful actress of N, please welcome Nkasi Ogbonnah. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Where can people find you?
You can find me on Instagram on Varnished Valkyrie. Yes. And you should know, I was just about to promote a show, and I was like, let me check the date. I thought it was on the 17th of this month. Turns out it's August 17th, so never mind.
Oh, boy. All right.
Yes.
Well
but check me out on Instagram.
Yes. And in August. Watch out.
Yes. Yes. Watch out for August.
Thank you. And last but not least, please welcome the actress playing Nectarine Spielberg Baldwin, Andrea Marston.
Hello.
Hello.
Very fun show. Thanks for having
yes.
me.
Yes. Where can people find more of you, Andrea?
You can find me on the internet at Pop Goes Andrea. And I will be on the Oval on Wednesday at 9 p.m.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Wigs will be worn.
There we go. Oh my goodness, thank you. Thanks so much for everyone watching. I'm Kiki Razzle, or Kirsten Rasmussen. You can find me at Kiki Razzle on socials. You can also find me playing on Proud and Funny this Saturday at 9 o'clock on Bad Dog TV. Happy Pride, everybody, and happy summer. And this was the last of our shows, so thank you so much for those who came out and gave us your amazing suggestions and supported Bad Dog in this show. Keep on supporting Bad Dog. They're going to be doing shows all through the summer. So keep checking it out and donating and subscribing to the channel. And you have yourself a wonderful night.